places, too, can be described with a wealth of details. Not only can they have a place name, of course, but they also have different characteristics in terms of location, and the location can be described extremely precisely. We can also give a very specific, very detailed description of the geopolitical name of a place, distinguishing between different levels. So you see that on the slide. You can have blocks containing several geopolitical units, several countries like OTAN or whatever. We can have the country, we can have the region within the country, we can indicate the settlement where this place name is located, and even the district, whatever kind of subdivision of settlement is relevant, like a quartier, a parish, a ward, whatever. So, we can give a description using properly geographic names. For instance, if you were describing the Mississippi River or the Mare Adriatico, there is no political element there, no block or country that would be relevant, but you can use the geog name and the geog feet elements to describe this purely geographic name. That is, geog name will contain the name Mississippi and geog feet river. River here is a geographic feature. Or speaking of the Mare Adriatico, the Adriatic Sea, geog feet will encode mare and the name will be simply Adriatico. All that wrapped into a geog name element. If we speak of the location, there are two ways of indicating the location of a place. You can have a geo element containing geographical information, that is geographic coordinates, GPS coordinates, basically. Or you can have a set of combination of more geopolitical elements describing the district, settlement, country, region, block of the place. And you can also have in location the address of the place. So let's see, for instance, how we could describe the University of Fribourg in Switzerland. So we have the place element, and inside the place we have two different place names, because Fribourg is a bilingual place, so you have the French and German-speaking version of the name, Université de Freiburg and Université de Fribourg. Then we describe the location of the place, giving the settlement here, a town, a city, where it is located, Fribourg, and we give the region, the wider political unit in which it is situated, which is the canton de Fribourg, and the country where it is situated, that is Switzerland. Then we give the location of the place with the location element, containing a geo element with the coordinates. That's something that will let us place this university on the map later. And we also give the address of the university, the postal address of the university. And that's about it. But of course, we could use many further elements to describe the place.